Yes, God. Thank you, God.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm so thankful to be back before you this evening because I'm excited and I have something to share that I know is going to bless you. When I last spoke to you on whatever platform it was, I was going into chemotherapy and God had removed the trepidations that I had, the fears and all that kind of thing, and I was going forth just believing that he was going to take me through and that there was going to be marvelous results. But I'm telling you, as I sit on the other side of round one, woo, I saw so many victories. The Lord previous to it had begun to sing to me. He said, and it was a song I'd heard about 25 years ago, and I'll just tell you the words. It says, "Walk on the water with me. You will not fail. You will not fail. Come on and walk on the water with me. You will not fail. You will not fail." And as I went, as I prepared to go that morning, he just orchestrated everything so that I would get there in plenty of time, accompanied by a person that is a praying person, my niece. And oh my God, my God. But the party started the night before when I got with Pastor Frazier and we prayed and we talked about miracles, and I had told her that I was standing on the scripture that you see, in front of, in the yellow box, and it says, hallelujah, it says, oh, glory to God, it says, ha, ha, let me get this thing right here so that you can see too. Woo, glory to your name, Jesus, glory to your name, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus, Jesus. Well, I hope you can see me. I know if you can't see me, you can hear me. But as I was saying, the party started the night before the round one of the infusion called chemotherapy. And Pastor Frazier and I were doing as we usually do when we get together. We were praying and doing all of that. Meanwhile, late that night, the Lord, we were talking about, back to Pastor Frazier, we were talking about miracle signs and wonders, and I was sharing that I was standing on that word in, what is it, Mark 16 and 18 that talks about how, if we get bit by a snake and if we drink poison, that God, he'll take us through it. He'll see us through that. One of y'all can get the scripture for that in a minute since I've messed up the screen. But in any case, I was standing on that scripture while the Lord was singing in my ear, "Walk on the water with me. You will not fail." Oh my God. So that morning we got there, and I got there early, and you have to go and you have to get your blood drawn, and then there's an hour wait between your blood being drawn and you're going into the room for the chemo. And so I walked into the place, the laboratory, and the person that greeted me and took me in told me that her name was a Victoria. And across the way from her, she introduced me to her cohort there, whose name was Victoria. Well, that sounded to me, coming from the one that had just begun to sing to me, "Walk on the water with me." He told me that was going to be a double victory. Victoria over there on the left, and Victoria over there on the right. Now, meanwhile, I'm in there to get my blood drawn, and I began to share a little bit about Victoria and about the victory that though we may go through bring us through, and we will see a victory. And she happened to be a believer on top of that. So, you know, when two believers touch and agree, you know, and she had her hand on there doing that thing they do when they draw your blood, it was like, oh, I'm thankful that God gave me two hands so I could have one up in the air and one not pulling the needle out. You know what I'm saying? And that she did that swiftly. And we began to chat just for a couple of moments. But that day started with a double victory and an assurance from the Lord that just like he said in Isaiah 43, when you go through deep waters, I will be with you. So I went on in. And we had talked, Weezy and I had talked about whether I was going to get a bed or get the chair or whatever. And as they led me in, into the room, it was early, and there weren't a lot of people there. And he took me into this room and said, she did, and asked me if that was all right. And it hit me, there was a view, and all I could see in this big old picture window in my chemotherapy room was a view of the water to keep my focus on what God had been saying to me. Oh, walk on the water with me. You will not fail. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I'm telling you today, if we heed what he says, if we go through with our eyes on him, we cannot fail. Our eyes have to be fixed on what he sets up for us or on him. Hallelujah. So every time anything would go a little bit awry in that room, all I could see was the water. You feel me? Hot. Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus. And not only was it a room with a view, but it was a room that was directly across from the restroom. One of my trepidations was having to drag that IV pole with me to the bathroom, you know? And he had me right, it was right across from the room. That's the favor of God. That's how he will do you when you walk on the water with him. Hallelujah. And that walk on the water has to be one of faith. And when the unbelief part of our faith kind of fails us, we can holler, as I tell my congregation, we can do like that man and say, hey, God, help my unbelief. And he comes through. Because he said he would be with us in the deep waters. Woo! Come on, walk on the water with me, he says. You will not fail. Bless the name of the Lord. So we're in there, and we're going on through the process, and they're giving me just tons and tons of information and instruction. Meanwhile, they're setting up the IV, because there's a stage that you go in before they actually put the chemicals in. And it was something else, because the Benadryl or whatever it was, it took me to a place I hadn't been to in over 30 years. You know, it was like, whoa, whoop in our land. And I'm telling you the truth, I kept asking him, how long is this gonna last? And then this was the setup for when they actually bring the chemicals in. And I'm telling you, oh my God. And then, you know, they have inundated you all throughout this in preparation for this with all this information of everything that can go on, of all of the side effects and all of that kind of thing. But Pastor Frazier and I had prayed, and my congregation had prayed, and those who know me and love me, who have been on the wire with heaven all throughout this process, were praying against negative side effects. Many were praying according to that scripture. That's I think it was 34 verse 7, where he says something about an angel, the angel of the Lord will surround you. Hallelujah. And that angel of the Lord, I believe that angel of the Lord is capable of, if God says so, because angels follow orders even if we don't. I believe that angel went in there with that chemo and directed. This is what we pray, that he would direct the guide, guide this process or that drug so that it would do what God wanted it to do and not do what it was, that it, the things that they would say in the report, you know? And so what happened in the midst of that? We were praying that and believing that God would no bad side effects, and that God would direct it, because you know what they say about chemo is that it's blind. It just goes in and destroys everything, including your immune system. It gets rid of the cancer cells, but it kills everything else around it that needs to be alive. And so we began to come against that, and we began to believe God that he would be the director with his angel or whoever, that he would direct that drug so that it would only do good and not harm, that there would be no negative side effects. I don't care what the reports have been all over the world. I stand on whose report will you believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. And I did. I had no fear that there would be a challenge with that. So I'm sitting there with the view of the water. God told me to walk on with him, and they're putting the stuff in, and it's a little loopy for a moment there, but that was I don't know what was going on with that. But then, you know, I had more trouble with that, as a matter of fact, because I was thinking, I said, my God. And I began to reflect back on the days that those days many, many, many years ago when I was on drugs. I said, whoa, in my sobriety, in my right mind, I was saying, how could I have gone down that road? This is crazy. And I kept saying to the guy, I said, when is this going to be over? Not talking about the chemo. I'm talking about the preventive drugs that you take before you go to chemo. And they kind of laughed at it because it was funny, because I was the way I said it, I'm sure. But it was that part of it. And then they began to infuse the chemo. First one, you know, about a 3-hour process. And then I'm looking around and I'm looking out the window and I ain't feeling a thing. I'm still feeling a little loopy from the stuff they gave me before. But the chemo was not having the negative effect that it would have, because my God was standing by and controlling where it went. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. And he'll do that. He'll do that. He'll do that. He'll do that. Hallelujah. He did it for me, and he's no respecter of persons. Hallelujah. So he did that. Huh? And then they brought on the other drug. There were two chemo drugs, and I did not feel a thing. And the next thing I knew, as I looked out upon the water, that bad boy was over 2.5 hours before it was supposed to be. I said, my God, my God, my God, what a mighty God you are. Huh? I said, because remember, a double victory is the way he started the day. Glory to your name, Jesus. That's the way he started the day. Huh? And the way that day ended, woo, or the way that portion of the day ended, my God, no ill effects. I walked out of there. Actually, they brought me a wheelchair because I didn't know quite when my ride was going to come, because she was in traffic. So they wheeled me down there, and I got up at when she called and found me. It was no thing, a matter of about 7 or 8 minutes or so, maybe even less than that. And so God was with me all throughout. Whew, double victory. That's one for each eye. Hallelujah. Double victory. That's more than a conqueror. I'm in view of the water, so I would know where to focus, so that I would remember the song that he sang to me that night and preceding nights before that. Whew, when he says he's going to go through deep waters with you, he means it. When he says that the Lord my God will call That's a victory through Jesus Christ. It will happen if you only trust, believe, obey. Hallelujah. I went because I had some challenges with that part of the treatment. I wasn't just going to go with it just because. But the Lord gave me up. He gave me the fleece that I needed. If you know the story of Gideon, he gave Gideon fleece after fleece. And he answered that for me. And I said, all right. All right, I'm gonna do it, and I did it, and this is just round one, but I'm here to tell you, if God says go, we have to go. If God says do, we have to do, and we have to understand that he is in the business of causing us to be victorious, especially in this hour. And that if the challenge, no matter how high the mountain, no matter how great the challenge, he's going to be with us. And as I thought more today about that business of him being large and in charge of what goes in our body, I began to think about what happens when anger goes in our body. What happens when sadness or grief kind of goes in like a cancer cell and begins to kind of take over and make you feel all kinds of ways? I thought about that and I said, well, if he can take care of these cancer cells, and if that when the what's going in there, it does not discriminate. If he can take care of that and rearrange what that drug can do, what won't he do when we are full of fear, when we are full of anger, when we are full of sadness, grief? He'll come in and he'll redirect things. He'll guide those emotions. That stack of emotions, he can do it in that situation too. Hallelujah, glory to your name. So that what goes on, you may get angry, but it will not do harm inside you if you walk on the water with him, entrusting it to him. The grief, the sadness, just keep giving it to him. Keep trusting him. Keep your eyes on him. Walk on the water with him and let him take care and be in control of everything. Walk on the water with him. You will not fail. I don't care what the mountain is, what the challenge is. God is there and nothing is impossible for him. It's a matter of us letting him, let him loose inside of you. Let him loose around you so he can literally transform a negative into a positive. We just need to be still, hands in the air, surrender. Just like you are when you're in surgery. I've never heard of anybody protesting after they've been knocked out in surgery. And that's how we have to be through these processes of life. When stuff comes in to attack our bodies. And don't you think for 1 minute that anger and that sadness and that grief is looking for something to attack inside of our bodies. Especially anger. But grief and sadness and depression and those kinds of things will come in and do damage too. But we don't have to take it. We got a God who rules earth and heaven. And in him there is relief for every pain and care. So we're going to go through. Whatever the challenge, we will go through. Isaiah 43:2, when you go through deep waters,
I will be with you.
I stand on that promise now. It's just been round one. This is the day after, the night after. I'm telling you, I feel better today than I did before, ever before. I feel strong, and it's not my strength. I'm standing in the strength of the Lord. I've had no nausea. I've had no challenge with eating. In fact, I will resist eating tonight again. Hallelujah. All of the negatives that they said would come with this haven't showed up, or they might have showed up, but God was standing by. Hey, boom, you can't come in here and mess with that one. And if he'll do that for me, I know that I know that I know that he's not a respecter of person, and he will do that for you. Rome with a view, so that I can remember the song that he sang. There will be times, come walk on the water with me, daughter. You will not fail. You will not fail. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, walk on the water with me. You will not fail.